tire company's gotta love you. What is this, test drive or what?
Well, yeah, test drove it. It's my new project.
Oh, Lord.
You always gotta have the bigger, badder, right? Just the natural progression. Taking a medium duty, putting our spin on it, our style to it, it's just gonna put us over the top again.
I'm scared to see what you're gonna come up with next after this one's that high. But I got you a bay open. Let's go ahead and pull it in there and we'll get it racked up.
So you got me a spot?
Got you a spot.
Let's do it. You know, always before starting a project like this, you always get a little anxious. Just, you know, you can't really wait to get started working on this. I mean, it's still, you know, a passion for all of us. It's the anticipation of getting the thing done, getting it out of the road, and just having a good time with it. It doesn't get any better than that. Most of the time you start out with a blank canvas, right? Well, in this case, we're gonna create the canvas and then add to that also. So the finished product is just gonna be something that's gonna blow everybody away. You know, I love being able to prove myself, to prove my team to everybody. Building a lifted truck, that's fun for me. But building a super huge dually truck that's gonna end up being, you know, over 12,000 pounds when we're done, super high off the ground, that's just something I gotta have in my life.
Bill can't leave well enough alone. He'd asked me to get two speakers out of the shop. So I brought him a box. He said, no, two boxes. So he's gonna have four more speakers through the front, so the back's gonna be loud, and now the front's gonna be loud.
My brand new Silverado medium duty is almost done. We're gonna add a winch and a place for even more speakers.
Man, this is exactly what this thing has to have, some kind of forward projection. So the 6.5-inch Wake Tower speakers are just perfect.
Really hope people like Bill's music. You're gonna be listening to exactly what he's listening to.
After all the work we did to the bed, it's time to get it over to body and paint so we can color match everything all black.
Welcome in, guys. Welcome in.
Now the only thing left is putting all the pieces together.
No more. Yeah.
We're installing the amp rack, running boards and speaker grills, huge billet dually wheels, and then it's ready for its world premiere. Every year we have an open house at the shop. We got friends, family, old customers, and hopefully some new ones. And I can't wait to show them what we've been up to.
It's always cool to, you know, have parties like this, have an open house, and just, you know, see what comes through the door. And
for sure.
Stuff like this is exactly what, you know, gets me excited. You know, you never know what's gonna come through the gate, but when you see a big mud truck and a monkey, you gotta go see what's going on. How old is he?
4 months.
4 months? Man, he's cool. Man, this thing's crazy.
You know, there's a certain kind of person that loves lifted trucks. And for them, a brand new Chevy 5500 medium duty, 14 inches in the air, is gonna blow them away.
Hey, you guys, come on over. I wanna show you guys something. Come on.
Come on, we're in.
Come on over.
For real, thank you guys for coming out, you know, and always supporting, you know, myself, my team, extensive. It says a lot to me, you know, you guys coming out, and I know it's free food and free beer, but thanks for coming.
Thanks, Bill.
When I got all you guys together, you know, I want you guys to check out the latest extensive build and tell me what you think.
Yeah!
All right, Timmy, come on out with it.
You know, another example of just teamwork makes the dream work. Brand new medium duty Silverado 5500 doesn't come like this. When I got this thing, it was just a cabin chassis, just basic work truck, no frills whatsoever. So first thing we did is got it in the shop, put it on the lift and got it at the height that looked good. Push the button again, a little higher. Push the button again, a little, all right, cool. Get the axles down in the right spot and just build everything from the truck down to the ground. Starting out with the big, huge four link underneath this thing, big bags. This thing gets 14 inches of lift from all the way down to all the way up, totally adjustable. You know, if you're gonna have a big 4x4 truck like this, you gotta have some unique, cool wheels on this thing. 28-inch dually wheels with big 42-inch tall tires. Yeah. You know, I wanted to go something totally different and do a utility bed. You know, nobody does a bed like this on a truck like this.
Typical build fashion, when we got the bed, couldn't leave well enough alone. You think you can bolt the bed on this thing? Yeah, I never worked with Bill Carlton. He had to change up the whole bed, taillights, side, added some speakers on the top.
Well, if you're gonna have a stereo, you gotta have a stereo. I wanted like a wakeboard style stereo in the headache rack. Somebody behind me, they ain't gonna be able to hear either. And we put 10 Rockford Tower speakers all throughout the bottom of this thing. So not only that, it's got 4 subs that fire down and out also. So this thing's gonna hit just as good. There's a ton of stereo just inside also. You know, we utilize every compartment in this thing just to be loud. From the speakers behind the grill to the winch, this thing's ready to party and get to work. And you gotta be able to get in this big old truck, right? So I had to make some steps, had to build some running boards and incorporated, you know, toolboxes in this thing just to break up some of the smoothness that's in between there. You know, tie everything together and give it a little style. I really appreciate all you guys coming out and checking this thing out. Another example, teamwork right here. And this is what happens. Everybody comes together and make some cool stuff. Awesome.